Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our online classes. At present, I am in 6th standard social study class. So, dear students, in the previous class, we already learned. In previous class, we already understand about Shatavahanas dynasty and their important kings, then their contribution in the religion and their literature work and their architecture. So these are all information we learned in the previous class. One more point belongs to that Shatavahanas, that is trade and towns. Trade and towns of Shatavahanas. So little bit information we have to understand now. Later on we have to move to the Kadambas of Varanasi. Now it is the time to understand trade and towns of Shatavahanas. The period of Shatavahanas enjoyed economic prosperity. It's a very highly reachable economic condition of the Shatavahanas. The main reason for this is the trade that took place within the country and inside of the outside of the country. So here they introduced Nigamas. Shatavahanas introduced Nigamas. What is the meaning of Nigamas? So here the Nigamas means the towns were called, the cities or the towns are called, Shatavahana people are called Nigamas. Then which are the important Nigamas during the time of Shatavahanas? Just you have to understand Paitham, Karni, Kanheri, Junna, and Nasik of Maharashtra, Dhanyaniketa of Andhra Pradesh, then Vaijayanti of Uttara Kannada district. These are the important Nigamas. Once again, I repeat that everyone should take this notes, very important notes. It is not belongs to Kadambas, it is belongs to Shatavahanas. Because of Shatavahanas, there is one more point remaining balance in there. That is the balance point is trade towns. What is the name they are called for towns? They are called towns called Nigamas. How, which are the prominent Nigamas? The very first one, the very first Nigama is Paithan. Paithan of the Shatavahanas. Paithan, Kale, Kanheri, Junna, Nasik of Maharashtra, Dhanyaniketa of Andhra Pradesh, Vaijayanti of Uttara Kannada. These are the important business center or trade centers of Shatavahanas. The next one is they are the towns and societies named Srenis. Here they are one more point is there, that is Sreni. Sreni means what? Here Nigama we already understand. Nigama means the cities or the towns of the Shatavahanas called Nigamas, as well as the Sreni here. Sreni means what? The towns. What is the meaning of Sreni means? Sreni means the towns and societies. Those societies name are called Sreni. Then they were the groups formed by professional and traders to protect their interest. For example, Dhanika Sreni was society of grocery merchants. Dhanika Sreni means what? He was the owner. He was the owner of the grocery merchants. Similarly, Smiths, Potters and others had their own societies. Sreni had a senior who was called Sreshti. The highest Sreni, that person name is called Sreshti. Sreni means it is the name of the society. Different society, different caste people are there in the Shatavahanas dynasty. So those different kinds of people are caste people, they are considered as Sreni. The highest caste or get the highest reward, that is the Sreshti. Have you understood? The highest caste, that person we have to consider as Sreshti. The next one is that the Sreshtis were usually rich. Who are very rich? Those are considered as Sreshti. Then the next one is that That is, one Srishti had built a Chaitya. Chaitya means what? In the previous class I explained about that. Chaitya means prayer hall. What is the meaning of Chaitya? Chaitya means prayer hall. Yes. What done the rich person? Rich person or Srishti built Chaitya. Chaitya means prayer hall during the time of Shatavahanas. Where is it there? Chaitya at Karle. The famous Chaitya we have to look at it in the place of Karle. Then Mullah carts, horse and donkeys were used to inland cargo movement. So this is the information we have to learn in the topic of trade and towns of the Shatavahanas. So towns are considered as nigamas, and these nigamas have different kinds of caste. Those caste people we have to consider as Sreni. The highest person, that means a very rich person, we have to consider him Sreshti. That is Sreshti built a Chaitya. Chaitya means prayer hall. Where they built the Chaitya? Chaitya built in the Karle. So this is the information we have to understand from the Shatavahanas' last concept, that is trade and towns. Now the concept of Shatavahanas' concept is over. So today I will send you textual question and answer. You should write in papers. But here we have to understand about the Kadambas of Banavasi. So before I am going to start this concept, Banavasi, early name is Vaijayantipura. What is the early name of Banavasi? Vaijayantipura. Vaijayantipura is the early name of Banavasi. So it is the capital city of Kadambas. Who was the first king? That means who founded this Kadambas? Here, Mayur Sharma. Mayur Sharma was the founder of Kadamba dynasty. Who were the prominent kings of Kadamba dynasty? Mayur Sharma. Then the second one is Kakutsa Varma. So these are the prominent kings of Kadambas. How to change his name Mayura Sharma into Mayura Varma? There is an incident that happened there. Once upon a time, Sivaskanda Varma was the king of Pallavas. So he insulted Mayura Sharma. For what reason he insulted to Mayura Sharma? Because he protected his princess. During the time of horse riding, at the time he fell down from the horse back. So at the time Mayura Sharma was one of the Brahmana, so he protected the princess people. During that time he, the Sivaskanda Varma, insulted Mayura Sharma. At the time there is no humanity of Mayura Sharma, but here Mayura Sharma converted into Mayura Varma and he established Kadamba. So Kadamba, there is a famous temple, that is Madhukeshwara temple. Madhukeshwara temple built by Kadamba dynasty emperor. So before that there is an incident happened. What is the incident? Do you understand? The Sivaskanda Varma was the king of Pallavas, insulted the Mayura Sharma for protected his son from fall down from the horseback. So that is the insult he targeted. He built a new dynasty, that is Kadamba. After he built a Kadamba dynasty, he defeated the Pallavas, Kanchi Pallavas. So that's why he converted his name Mayura Sharma into Mayura Varma. Have you understood? The next point is there, that is here Mayura Varma. We already understand about that Mayura Varma. There is one more important concept is there. What are the contributions? We already understand 3 points. Which is the capital city of Kadamba? Kadamba's capital city is Banavasi. What was the early name of Banavasi? Banavasi early name Mayurpuram. Who is the founder of Kadambas? Kadambas founder is Mayur Sharma, not Mayur Varma. Before his name, Mayur Sharma. For what reason Mayur Sharma converted as Mayur Varma? There is incident I have already explained. And next, who are the prominent kings of Kadambas? Kadambas prominent kings were, first one is Mayur Varma, then second one is Kakutsa Varma. Kakutsa Varma was the uncle. That means he is the brother of his father. That's why he is the uncle of Mayura Sharma. Both the kings are the prominent kings of Kadambas. Now it is a time to understand about the contributions of Kadambas. Here, the first point we have to understand religion. Religion, they were Shaivas and worshipped Pradeshwara of Talunga. Here, the Shatavarna belongs to Vedic people. Veda, Vedic people and Vedic religion they are followed. Here, Kadambas followed the Shaivas. Shaiva Pantha, that is the name of the religion they are following. And also, who is the god? The home god of the Kadambas? The home god of the Kadambas is Pradeshwara. So, as well as Madhukeshwara is the home god of Kadambas of Vanavasi. The next one is that Pradeshwara Inga of Talagunda is the most recent Sivalinga of Karnataka. Kadambas respected Buddhism, Vaishnava religion, thereby they established religious tolerance. Here, not only these people are Shaivas, they are even more important to Vaishnavas and Buddhist people. So they are given more importance to other religions also. So here, dear students, I hope you understand about the trade and towns of the Shatavarnas concept, and that concept is completed. The next concept is Kadambas Vanavasi. In that, now we have to understand brief information about Kadambas and the combination of religion concept. In the next period, we have to understand literature and education. Okay?